Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for Current Affairs. So let's begin this video. Guys, this is the schedule of live classes for RDSAB and NABARD. And this is our mobile application which you can download from the Play Store. So here we have the first question. Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers has announced the launch of the One Nation, One Fertilizer initiative from October 2nd. As part of the initiative, crop nutrients, urea, diammonium phosphate and muriate of potash will be sold under a single brand named Bharat, irrespective of the manufacturing companies. Under which scheme is this initiative launched? So here the right answer is option D. Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Urvarak Pariyojana. Now Urvarak is the in Hindi word for fertilizer, okay? So from there you can remember the scheme itself. Bharatiya Jan Urvarak Pariyojana. Now what is this initiative? Under this initiative, all the fertilizers would be sold under a single brand name, and that brand name is Bharat. And you all know that why do we give a brand name to a product? In order to increase its market value. So that is the basic idea here. Now do remember that this initiative has been launched under the central government's Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Urvarak Pariyojana. So this scheme is your homework. Do cover this scheme thoroughly from the government schemes document and do tell me when was this scheme launched. Moving ahead, where will the 20th edition of Bio Asia be organized? So it is basically a conference type of an event, not exactly a conference but a platform given to the healthcare stakeholders, so that they can come together and discuss the new solutions, they can showcase the new technologies in the field of healthcare at this Bio Asia event. So it is organized by the government of Telangana in Hyderabad every year, okay? So Telangana government organized karti hai isko, okay? Now here what are the things that you need to remember? First is the edition, 20th edition. Second is the place, Hyderabad. And it is going to be held in 2023. So that is not a very important fact for you to remember, but it's just for your information. Now theme is advancing for one, shaping the next generation of humanized healthcare. Now this is the theme of this Bio Asia event. You need to cover the theme because theme can be asked. The next question is, which state has recently launched the credit guarantee scheme on the lines of the credit guarantee trust for micro and small enterprises? So here guys, Tamil Nadu is the right answer. Now what is this credit guarantee trust for micro and small enterprises? So I am going to briefly tell you the idea of this scheme so that you can understand this state scheme better. I hope that you have covered this central government scheme thoroughly because this remains all the time in news. So do cover this if you haven't covered it by now. So what is the basic idea of this scheme? Credit guarantee trust. So it is basically a trust which gives the guarantee against the credit taken by the MSMEs. Okay, so government gives guarantee to the banks so that the banks lend to the MSMEs. Okay, because in order to provide or prevent the banks from incurring more and more NPAs, the government gives the guarantee against the loans taken by the MSMEs, and this guarantee is not given for all the loans that all the MSMEs in India have taken so far. This guarantee was given for the specific loans that the MSMEs have taken during the COVID period, okay, in order to push the growth of these MSMEs. So that is the basic idea. On the similar lines, Tamil Nadu credit guarantee scheme also works. Now let's understand the functioning of this scheme. So this state scheme basically gives the guarantee of up to 90% for the loans which are up to 40 lakhs, and the guarantee of 80% is given for loans which are ranging in between 40 lakhs to 2 crores. Okay, the loans which are above 40 lakhs, on those loans the state government is going to give 80% guarantee. So that is the basic idea. Okay, and rupees 100 crore is the total allocation for this scheme by the state government. And do remember that these two schemes, the state scheme and the central government scheme, these two schemes are separate schemes. However, the structure of these two schemes are same. Okay, so I hope that this much is clear to all of you. I hope that you are not getting confused about the meaning of this guarantee. The meaning of this guarantee is that out of the 40 lakh rupees, 36 lakh is guaranteed by the government and the rest 4 lakh, which is 10% of the 40 lakh, is not guaranteed. So this is the responsibility of the MSME to pay back to the bank. Okay, so that is the meaning of the guarantee. Now one more initiative has been launched by the Tamil Nadu government for MSMEs only. That initiative is Trade Receivable Discounting System. Now if you don't know the working of this Trade Receivable Discounting System, I am going to give an example so that you can understand it. So suppose A is a buyer, B is a seller. This B has sold goods to A and in return it has written an invoice on the name of A. Okay, so this A says that right now I don't have money, I will give you the money after 3 months. Okay, so 3 months is the time. Now what happens? The B needs the money urgently. Earlier B thought that okay, 3 months time is enough for me, but it did not know, B did not know that I would need money so early. Now there is an emergency and B needs the money urgently. Now he cannot go to A and ask for the money because according to the contract or the invoice, the time limit is 3 months. So what is the option for B now? It is going to go to a third party. This third party would be a financier. So B would go to C and say that you take my invoice, and suppose this invoice is of rupees 100, take my invoice of rupees 100 and give me the cash. Now the C would say, what is my benefit in this? So C would give B rupees 95 and the remaining 5 rupees would be the commission of C, because this is a business and C needs to earn something to run his own business as well. So this is the business of C, therefore the discount of the trade receivable, this is the trade receivable for B. Now this has been discounted by C and the ultimate amount which B has got is rupees 95. Now what is the benefit? Why did B go to C and asked for only rupees 95? The benefit is of time. B needed the money urgently, therefore it went to C and asked for the money. Had it been that B needed the money after 3 months, obviously he would ask the money directly from A, the entire rupees 100. But right now, due to the emergency, it went to C and asked for the money. So this entire thing is the trade receivable discounting system. Now this system has been launched by the Tamil Nadu government, because this is the online system. And this online system is for MSMEs. So all the MSMEs can upload their bills on this online system and get in the money in return through this platform only. Now they don't have to go to each and every financier and ask for the money in this return for their trade receivable. That is the benefit of this trade receivable discounting system launched by the Tamil Nadu government. Okay. So I hope that now you have understood both the schemes well. The next question is, which state has signed an MOU with the Confederation of Indian Industry for establishing startup cohorts and conduct capacity building programs to collaborate and unleash the potential of entrepreneurial talents? So here, NARAL and the ICC right answer. Now what is the basic idea of this news? The crux of this news is that Confederation of Indian Industry and the Nagaland government have signed an MOU. They both are going to unleash the potential of the youth. Unleash the potential means basically they are going to conduct the capacity building courses, training courses, and they are going to give opportunity to the startup so that they can get a platform, they can get funding, and they can basically scale up their idea. That is the basic idea. Okay? Now this MOU was signed at the Nagaland CSR Investment Conclave 2022, which is titled as Partnership for Strengthening Sustainable Development. Now guys, I have already told you that as part of this MOU, the CII would establish startup cohorts And these startup cohorts will basically guide the startups in the state of Nagaland and conduct the capacity building courses for the Nagaland government official, financial institution, banks, incubators, academic innovation cells. So all of the fields are covered by the capacity building courses of CII. Now, Indian Navy has also collaborated with Nagaland in order to provide innovation and indigenization support to the state. A modern career center will also be established in Nagaland with the help of the state government. The next question is, Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare, Shri Narendra Singh Tomar, laid the foundation stone of the Indo-Israel Center of Excellence for Vegetables in Chandauli, Uttar Pradesh. The climate of Chandauli district, which is known as the rice bowl of UP, is suitable for setting up the Center of Excellence for Vegetables. How many agroclimatic zones are present in the state? Now focus on the word state. It does not ask you the agroclimatic zones of India. However, there could be the statement which can ask you how many agroclimatic zones are there in India. So you have to pay attention to the words here. Okay, each and every word is important from this question, because prior to this statement, we were talking about this Chandauli district only. But this statement highlights the importance of the state's agroclimatic zone. So here my intention behind telling you all this is, please read the question carefully. So here, what is the right answer? How many agroclimatic zones are there in Uttar Pradesh? Total 9. Now, if you are surprised to know that states also have agroclimatic zones, then let me tell you, yes. Not only India, but states also have agroclimatic zones. Guys, understand this point. What is the reason for distinguishing or classifying any area as the agroclimatic zone? To plan the agriculture according to the climate. Therefore, not only at the national level, but at the state level also, agroclimatic zones are divided. But it is not important for you to remember all the agroclimatic zones of each and every state. Just remember the zones which are there in news, like this. Uttar Pradesh zones were there in news, therefore we are discussing it. Now coming back to the news. So, Indo-Israel Center of Excellence for Vegetables has been, the foundation stone for this center has been laid in Chandauli in Uttar Pradesh. Chandauli district is also known as the rice bowl of UP. This is again a very important fact, because from here only a question can be made. Now guys, there are 9 climatic zones in the state which are cultivable, which are suitable for the cultivation of horticulture crops throughout the year. So these are very factual facts. I cannot explain them further. So I hope that you are understanding the points here and you can easily remember these points, because there is nothing complex to these points. Now coming to this Israel and India collaboration for the Center of Excellences and Villages of Excellence. So understand this point, that India and Israel have collaborated for setting up the Center of Excellences, and around these Center of Excellences, the Villages of Excellence would be created. So at present, we have 29 Center of Excellences in 12 states, and the highlighted or the underlying facts are important. Okay, so this is the data of January 2022. So as per this data, India has 29 Center of Excellences operational in 12 states. And around these 29 Center of Excellences, India and Israel have announced to establish 150 Villages of Excellence. Now out of these 150 Villages of Excellence, 75 villages will be created in the first year, that is the current year. Okay. Now why 75? Because 75 is the year of we are celebrating the 75th year of independence. So 75 villages of excellence will be created in this year. So that is the basic news all about. Now what is the village of excellence or center of excellence? These center of excellences are going to promote the agriculture in India. Okay. These center of excellences are focused on the agriculture only. Okay, that is the basic idea. The next question is, recently Airports Authority of India and LFVA Navigation Services have signed an MOU to explore smart aviation solutions for developing sustainable aviation technology. Which country does the latter belong to? So the latter belongs to Sweden. Sweden is the right answer. And the basic idea is to collaborate so that they can create new technologies to make aviation sustainable. Question number 7 is, what is the name of the new initiative launched by the BOB, Financial Solutions Limited and Indian Army for offering credit card to the army personnel? So here Yodha is the right answer. Okay, now it is a very simple news. BOB Financial Solutions Limited, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of BOB, Bank of Baroda. Okay, very easy to understand this point, no need to muddle this fact. So BOB Financial Solutions Limited and the Indian Army have launched Yodha, and Yodha is basically a card, credit card. Now this credit card is being offered with the help of the National Payments Corporation of India. So this National Payment Corporation of India is backing BOB Financial Solutions Limited for launching or providing this RuPay credit card named as Yodha to the Indian Army, because it is a RuPay credit card and RuPay is administered by the NPCI. Therefore, the NPCI is also a stakeholder in this MOU. Okay, so this is basically co-branded credit card and it will be equipped with contactless feature and it will be offered on the RuPay platform. And this is not important for you, for your examination. This is for your understanding. Okay, so if you understand it, then it's well and good. If you don't understand it, then just leave it. It's not important. How much stake will HDFC acquire in the Go Digit Life Insurance? So here the right answer is option 9.94% stake will be acquired by the HDFC. Yes guys, such kinds of questions are asked in the examination. The percentage of the stake, the amount, especially in NABARD and SEBI, I have seen these weird questions where they are asking the amounts of the IPOs as well. So here you can definitely expect the amount or the percentage of the stake that India's largest private bank is acquiring in an insurance company. Next question is, which company has launched the All Things EV, India's first one-stop solution portal for electric vehicles? So here HDFC again. HDFC Ergo General Insurance Company is the right answer. Now this is a portal where every information related to the electric vehicles will be available. Who is the new chairman of DRDO? So it is Samir V. Kamath. Okay, so Samir V. Kamath has been appointed as a new chairperson of DRDO, Defence Research and Development Organization, as well as he has been appointed as the Secretary of Department of Defence. Okay, and prior to his appointment as the Chairman of DRDO, he was working as the Director General of Fuel Systems and Materials. Okay, so this is another information related to him. So here guys, this video ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching it. If you have any feedback or anything to ask from me, you can mention it in the comment section below. Thank you so much. Have a good day.